If you are looking to dynamically filter information on a form in Airtable, you have come to the right place. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how we can dynamically filter information that people can connect to in a form. I'm going to be using an example of cities in states so that when a user picks a state, they only see the cities that are linked to that state. I'm going to show you how to build all of this from scratch. So if understanding dynamic filters in Airtable is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, and we've been working in no-code tools, specifically Airtable, for many years now on this channel. So if you are looking for ways to improve your Airtable savvy, I strongly recommend you subscribing to this channel and checking out all of our content. Now, as I said in this video, we're going to be diving into dynamic filters. But before we get to that, I first want to invite you to join me for some free Airtable training. If you want to get caught up quickly in Airtable, learn all the basics, all the key building blocks, I've put together something I call my Airtable Crash Course. You can sign up for free with your email address at gapconsulting.io/airtable-crash-course, and we'll deliver you little bite-sized pieces of Airtable nuggets over the next several days until you have mastered the basics. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen and get started with the whole key takeaways of today's video. We're looking at dynamic filters. Now, first, we need to understand why you might use this. Dynamic filters are when we are connecting to two different places and we want to connect to thing one and then only see thing two connections that are relevant for thing one. So that sounds a little bit nebulous when we're speaking in terms of things. So let's actually do a real life example of states and cities. So I'm in the United States, and here I've built an example on a first table called states, and I've listed out California, Florida, and Texas. And you'll notice that these three different states are linked to cities. In fact, each state connects to five cities. So if we actually look over at our second table, you'll find the cities that we're looking at. And for our example, this is thing two, as I referenced earlier. So we've got these different cities. In the case of California, you'll see we've got Los Angeles, Fresno, Bakersfield, San Diego, and San Francisco, and they're linked back to the state of California. Down here, we've got five different cities for Florida, and we have five different cities for Texas that are linking back to their respective states. So here's our example. Remember, we're thinking in terms of linking to thing one and then seeing relevant data for thing two. So in our example, we imagine a form where somebody might fill out what state they're looking for, and then they only want to see the five cities from that state. So if I filled out my form and I picked California first, I would only want to see these five options for cities. That makes sense, because these are the ones that are related to this particular state. So this is how we build that in Airtable. Number one, we build a table for thing one. Thing one in our example is states. Then we build a table for thing two, which is our cities for our example. And then the third component here is going to be where we are building our form, because in our form, when people submit it, they're going to be connecting to both a state and a city, which means we need a third table. And so I've built a table that I've called submissions. And by default, submission starts with these three records, which I don't need, so I'll delete them. But you'll notice that I've connected our third table to both the state and the city. Now, right now, if I went in here and I put in a submission, I would choose, you know, California as an example, and then I'm going to see in my cities all of the different cities that we have in our list. I'm not just going to see the cities that are related to California, which is what I want. But here, as you see, I'm pulling back all of the cities in Texas, the cities in Florida, and then also the cities in California that are in my database. So first things first, I need to build the dynamic filter that says, after somebody picks the state, then I'm going to dynamically filter the information that shows up in the city. And I'm going to do that in the settings here for the city. So a double click here, or alternatively, I can click here and go into edit the field. And once I'm in here, I can look at filtering down the selections. The third option on the list is filter record selection by a condition. Now, this is a relatively new feature in Airtable that came out in 2024, if I recall correctly. And what we want to do is not set a stagnant rule, a static rule. We want instead a rule that's very flexible, one that's going to change with us depending on what we picked earlier. So it used to be that we could come in and only say, look, I only want to show where the state is California or where the state is Texas. But this is static. This does not change depending on what someone's already picked for the state. We want it to be dynamic, and that's where this more advanced feature comes into play. So let's actually, instead of putting it in this way, click on this gear icon here and go down to our dynamic condition. This is now where we can say, I want you to match the state in here. So let's save this really quickly and then go back and get an understanding of what this is showing us. So in our cities table, we have a linked relationship to the state. And so we're saying on our submissions that we only want to show a city where the states on the city's table matches the state that's been picked here inside of our submission. So I realize there's a couple of layers of complexity here, but if you build your linked relationships the way I've demonstrated, you will be able to get this. And now when I've saved this filter, now when I look at my cities, I only see the cities that match California. But if I were to pick a different state, let's go with Texas, now I'm going to see the cities that match Texas. So we've almost got this completely built out. We've got our dynamic filters working, but now for the fun stuff where we actually build a form and share it with people who are going to be giving us that information. In order to build our form, we'll go up to the top here and click on forms, and we are going to now open up a form. And for us, we're making sure that this form is built on our third table, the new submissions table. So make sure that that is your source here. You want the source of your form to be whatever that third table is. And then we need to, at a minimum, on our form, ask two different questions. For us, it's thing one and thing two, which is state and city. So match those to whatever your thing one and your thing two is. Now for a couple of highlights. Now you'll see that if I select state here, it's going to follow the same rules that I've established in my database. So back here, I've picked Florida. Now if I go to city, I'm only going to see the five cities that are connected to Florida. This is exactly what I want. Now down here on the right-hand side of my setup in the form, you're seeing that it's telling me that my record selection may be limited, but that's exactly what I want. My field configuration, which is what I just worked on back in my database, was intentionally limited so that I'm only seeing the cities that connect to the state. But now for one more slightly advanced feature, we can make sure that people always pick a state first before they pick a city. Because if we don't have that rule in place and somebody does not pick a state and then they're inside of our form, they're going to see all the cities. And we don't want them to match up Bakersfield and then turn around and go to Texas, because Bakersfield's a city in California and this makes no sense. So we don't want them to fill it out backwards and therefore give us bad data that we don't want. We want to make sure we're protecting the integrity of the data in our form submissions. So to do this, let's make sure that we set visibility for the city. Select city, or whatever your thing two is. And now that we've highlighted this second component, we're gonna go on the right-hand side and look at our visibility rules. Now it'll probably say, always show this field on your screen. So let's go ahead and change this. We're gonna build a condition that says, well, state, the state field must not be empty. If it is empty, we don't want you to pick a city, because we want you to pick the state first and then pick the city. So we're saying where the state is not empty. That is when we're going to show this field on our form. So let's go ahead and publish the form now, and we can go to share the form, and we can share it either publicly on a URL with anyone on the web or just to people on the base. Let's go with anyone on the web. Of course, we're okay with this. It's warning us that, hey, people might see the linked relationships to the data in your base. That's okay. That's good for me. I'm going to dismiss this. I'll copy this link. This is a live link for a brand new form that we built in Airtable. I'm pasting it in a new window and opening it up. So obviously I've got some cleanup I could do on the form. I could change the title of group one, but what I care about is that thing two, cities, does not show up yet until I pick a state. Let's pick a state, Florida. Now magically, city has shown up and it's dynamically filtered for just the five cities that are linked to Florida. I'll pick Tampa, I'll submit. Let's submit another response to test it out. This time I'll pick Texas. Again, filtered now down to the five cities that we've linked to Texas. I'll go with Austin, I'll submit. That data is being immediately brought back into our database in Airtable. I can go back to view the data and I'll see that it's being captured here in my third table, Florida, Tampa, Texas, Austin, just like we demonstrated. You'll notice that our second thing, in our case cities, it was always dynamically filtered based on what we picked for thing one, in our case state. So there's a little tip for you. Make sure to hide that second thing. Make sure it only shows up after people have picked the first thing, and then build the dynamic relationship in your field settings back here inside of Airtable. Not on the form itself, but in the field settings, you can establish the dynamic relationship that you're trying to get here. I know we went pretty quickly in this video, so any questions you might have, feel free to swing by our website, which I will link below. And as I already mentioned, if you got value from this video, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. That's it for now, but most importantly, keep on building.